The Harvest Show, where faith makes a world of difference.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to a brand new edition of The Harvest Show. I have a question for you. Is your favorite food on the holiday hit list? Doctors Michele and Mark Sherwood reveal the top five foods to stay clear of this holiday season. And the Bible says we are to worship God, but what does that really mean? And what does it look like to be a worshiper? Pastor Mark Lantz shares his perspective in today's teaching. You guys, we made it, and America is watching. I'm just so happy to be here, so grateful to be here, and you'd have to be here in the Midwest to know what I'm talking about. I'm going to yield to Chuck Freebie so he can explain what is happening.
What's going on
with the
there?
Weather today?
Well, we have a wind coming off Lake Michigan from the northwest, and so that gives us a little thing called lake effect snow. And if you're watching us in Buffalo or Cleveland, you know all about this. But basically, the lake hasn't frozen up yet. So the water is still warm enough, and the cold wind comes over it, picks up the water, and it dumps it. And right now, it's dumping it on the south side of South Bend. And so my colleague here had to have a little help from the South Bend Police Department today to help her get to work.
That's right. And I don't know your name or your face, but I want to tell you thank you. I am so sorry you fell down while pushing my car up the hill. And that's exactly what happened. But it wasn't just me. See, the guys here in the studio, they want to laugh and say, you know, I just don't know how to drive because I'm from Florida.
Not today.
That's not the case. I was in a line of probably 12 to 15 cars, and he had to help each car.
So he was out of his squad car.
He was out of his squad car.
Trying to help push up. Up a hill?
Up a hill. You know that hill on Ironwood.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's treacherous. And it was so slippery and icy. And I just went into an instant prayer meeting. Yes. And what about your commute?
It took quite a bit longer, almost an hour to get in today. And I take the bypass in, kind of like a highway.
Yeah.
It was like a sheet of ice. And cars pointed the wrong way off this side of the ditch, out that side of the ditch as well. There's a car right here, a little Fiat 500. Somebody's braving the weather in a Fiat 500 today just outside of our station, way off the ditch, and they're trying to get him out right now. But apparently this whole weekend, across a big swath of the Midwest and the United States, it's going to be cold, and there's going to be a lot of snow blowing around, and it's going to be a little treacherous. So a good time to stoke up the fire, grab a good book, movie, and spend some time with your loved ones there in and at home.
That's right, but don't eat a lot of foods that may be on the holiday hit list. What are some of the things you guys like to eat? I know it's on the list.
The guilty pleasures?
The guilty pleasures. I'm waiting for Dr. Michele to tell me don't eat that macaroni and cheese because I love to eat that during the holidays. Baked ham, macaroni and cheese, green beans, you can't go wrong with that.
Green beans, as long as you keep the cream of mushroom soup and the fried onions off of it, sure, you'll be fine. Green beans are perfectly fine.
I don't put anything on my green beans. I cook them, and that's it. No butter, no salt, no cream of mushroom, any of that.
There you go, healthy as you can be.
Are you cooking this holiday season?
Yeah, I'm always cooking the holiday season.
Okay.
Yeah, and enjoy it. And we don't have too many guilty pleasures. I mean, we might grab some cake or something like that. We've kind of been, we're off the sugar train as
That's
a family.
Right.
And you've done a great job. You've lost.
I've kept off about 85 pounds over the last 3+ years or so.
Terrific.
Yeah, putting it back on my face, though.
At least 5 pounds of hair, right?
Yeah.
Okay, please explain the beard for us again, because we had a viewer
to write in. Well, it started with the no-shave November.
Right.
Right? And then I came in December 1, I said, I can't do it. Don't do it December. It's going to be just keep it January. And we'll see how long the alliterations go. Forever February, you know. Man, this beard is looking good March. And we'll see what happens.
And as long as your wife likes it, who cares? Okay.
That's right.
We want to know your thoughts. You can share them with us on the Harvest Show Facebook page. Share your 2 cents with us on Twitter and at live@lesea.com. Don't go anywhere. World News begins right now.
It is Thursday, December 15th, 2016. Here's what's happening in your world. Evacuation efforts are underway in Aleppo as residents have poured into the streets hoping to get out of that war-torn city. Syrian activists say residents in eastern Aleppo are starting to board buses and ambulances. That's the first step in an evacuation that is part of the rebel enclave's effective surrender. A spokeswoman for the International Committee of the Red Cross says their staff has arrived with Syrian Arab Red Crescent ambulances and workers trying to evacuate 200 wounded people, some of whom are in critical condition. The mayor of Aleppo met today with European Council President Donald Tusk for talks in Brussels. Brita Hagi Hassan lashed out at the inaction of the international community.
50,000 civilians of eastern Aleppo are only waiting for their death. After the failure of the international community and the failure of the Security Council of the UN to impose a humanitarian truce.
After the meeting, Hassan told journalists the EU needs to find a courageous solution to the trouble in Syria. Residents living in a Jewish outpost in the West Bank who face being permanently evacuated from their homes stressed they wish to stay, saying, "This is our land." Settlers in the Amona outpost rejected an offer from the Israeli government to leave the 50 trailers they live in voluntarily and face being forcefully evicted by security December 25th. The settlement was deemed by an Israeli court in 2014 to have been illegally built on Palestinian land. A breach of email provider Yahoo is the tip of the spear, according to one internet security expert. Will Donaldson, the CEO of data security service Nomex, said there are likely to be more problems with cloud data security in the future.
So even if that person doesn't keep their financial information or medical information online, by having the credentials and logging in, it's easy to spoof that person. It's easy to act as that person.
Wednesday, Yahoo revealed a hack occurring in August of 2013 had taken personal information from more than 1 billion user accounts. And a rare snowstorm brought Oregon's largest city to a halt Wednesday. Thousands of vehicles barely able to move on the streets of Portland and one of its main highways. Cars fishtailed, spun out, and collided. Semi-trucks littered Interstate 5, some of them unable to move to the side before getting stuck. Snow is also reaching into upstate New York. Some schools and government offices closed early ahead of another round of lake effect snow expected to dump 1 to 2 feet. Temperatures are well below freezing all the way from North Dakota to Pennsylvania. There's Valerie's car this morning. Coming up later, Pastor Mark Lantz talks about what it really means to have continual fellowship with God in today's connections. But up next, Drs. Michele and Mark Sherwood reveal the top 5 foods to stay clear of this holiday season. We're right back with more Harvest after this.
Got Facebook? Follow The Harvest Show.
Comment and share your opinions on current events.
See new after the show guest interviews.
Watch my updates and inspiration from Israel exclusively for Facebook.
Facebook.com/The Harvest Show. Like us today.
The Word of God has the power to transform broken lives, but only if we share it with those who don't know the good news. Each $5 you give between now and December 31st will provide a Bible to one person. A gift of $5 provides one Bible, $25 sends 5, and a gift of $180 provides a case of 36 Bibles to those in need. Pray about your gift and then call 1-800-365-3732 to give today.
LeSEA Prayerline.
Being healthy and even losing weight during the holidays is not only attainable, it's relatively easy. Moment of silence. So say national health experts, Drs. Mark and Michele Sherwood. This dynamic duo of health and wellness have been featured on multiple TV networks, Family Circle Magazine and the Huffington Post. And together, they founded and operate the Functional Medical Institute, which has helped thousands of patients nationwide. So good to have you with us today. Thanks for being here and making the effort on this terrible day outside.
Good to
but
be here.
Very appropriate for this holiday season. And, you know, everyone's figuring, well, we're going to put on 5 or 10 pounds and we're going to indulge and splurge. But you say it's relatively easy to stay healthy when the temptations are kind of sometimes maybe overwhelming. How is that?
Well, you have to kind of look at this time of year as not a time of year to go backwards, but a time of year to go forwards. Many times we wait, you know, Stephen and Valerie, until the beginning of the year to kind of undo what has been done. Mm-hmm. So this time of year, we want people to just kind of understand life and really understand that this is about a time of giving and not taking away from our health. So mm-hmm. we want to be a little more cautious, if you will, regarding the selections of food we eat and just kind of be aware of it yeah. and realize that we don't have to go backwards and just have to, as I was telling you before the segment came on, your why has to be pretty strong. You know, your reason has got to be health.
Right. Yeah. Now, I'm sure you've got some great tips and some do's and don'ts, but are there some things that you should absolutely stay away from, doesn't matter what time of the year it is?
Well, we always talk about the top five foods that you should avoid. Number one is sugar. We know that sugar causes inflammation. It causes us to age quickly. It produces age glycosylated end products in the body, something that we really didn't used to know about. But inflammation is the precursor to all chronic sickness and disease. So sugar, get it out. Number two, artificial sweeteners.
Okay.
It's in everything.
So even the substitutes that are chemically based.
They are chemically based. Mm-hmm. And we forget that everything we put into our bodies, every cell in your body has to see it. Not only your liver cells, your kidney cells, but your brain cells. And nobody wants to lose their mind. Mm-hmm. And if we start to think about what we're putting in our system as gasoline, is this gasoline good for me or bad for me? Mm-hmm. Like you said, chemical is not good. Mm-hmm. Then the trans fats and the hydrogenated oils, okay. those are not real fats. Those are not things that create healthy cell membranes, fluidity in the body. If you put the good oils in your system, it's like changing oil in the engine of your car. So we try to avoid those trans fats and hydrogenated oils.
Mm-hmm. A lot of the eating that takes place during the holidays is based on emotions. You know, I'd imagine, I don't know, Dr. Mark, is that true? And so when your emotions are not intact, you start to eat out of whack, I guess.
That is so true. You know, we typically eat because we want to feel better. And unfortunately, this time of year, instead of bringing joy many times in people's lives, it brings great sadness because they think about the wrong things instead of the right things. And when you think about the wrong things, of course, your emotions are going in the tank and you want something to make you feel better. Few people understand that sugar operates in the same neurotransmitters or reward centers as cocaine. So it does make you happy. It's a false sense of happiness, but it's kind of an addiction that we get on a train and we can't get off. So it's really good to understand our comforter, not to be over spiritual, of course, but the comforter is our Heavenly Father. And we need to understand that all of our needs are met through Him. All of our happiness is through Him instead of through, you know, the false friend of food, if we call it like that.
Okay, so what about some, I'm sorry, because I really want to know what not to do this holiday season. What about some of the substitutes? Like,
that's exactly what I was going to ask.
You know, what are some of the substitutes that we can have that are healthy in the categories that you said to stay away from?
Well, some of the things that we put in there are like xylitol, stevia. Stevia comes from a plant, and it does not affect insulin.
Xylitol as well? It's natural?
Xylitol is natural. Erythritol. The sugar alcohols we have to be careful not to get too much of because they can agitate the stomach. But the sugar alcohols do not affect the blood sugar insulin phenomenon that goes on and creates fat storage. Mm-hmm. And stevia is a plant that doesn't affect insulin either. And it does not have a negative effect on the system. Mm. When we're looking at oils, of course, we can use good coconut oil, things like macadamia nut oil, even almond oil. There's other oils that are healthy, even olive oil, to use for cooking. We even put coconut oil in our coffee. We call it bulletproof coffee in the morning.
Yes. Yeah. I learned about that last year in Australia.
It's fantastic. Great.
It's amazing.
Great fat burner. Great satiety will keep you full.
Yeah.
Some other things you can kind of use is you can substitute your wheat flours for almond flours, which is a terrific idea. Mm-hmm. We want to be a little careful with the white flours, of course, these days, even the wheat flours. So when you substitute the almond flour, you can do a little cooking that's kind of appealing to you and create the dishes you want to create with good ingredients.
So with the substitutes, let me ask you this, like stevia, I know you can get stevia, you can get coconut oil, you can get almond flour and coconut flour and others. But when it comes to cooking, does it change the way you got to do things? Is there a new learning process, or is it simply a substitution of A for B?
Well, one of the biggest things is its taste. You know, sometimes we have to change the taste that we get used to with a canola oil or a safflower oil. Mm-hmm. The good things about things like coconut oil is it's got a higher smoke point. So the charred meats create polycyclic hydrocarbons, which can be toxic to the system. The good thing about coconut oil is it can handle a higher heat. Mm-hmm. When you're cooking with olive oil, you have to cook at a lower heat because its smoke point is lower.
Mm-hmm. With the new year coming up, just kind of moving ahead here a little bit, because you know, this time of year, people are making resolutions and saying, okay, the first exercise thing I see on TV, I'm buying that thing, and we're going to make it work this year. Any advice on making resolutions and sticking with a longer-term plan to stay healthy and to stay well?
Yeah, a couple things, of course. Don't wait till January 1st. There's no time mm-hmm. like the present. I mean, this is a year about gifts and presents, so why not start today? You can't repeat this moment, so start your New Year's resolutions right now. And goal-wise, you want to start small. You want to kind of, as I say, failure-proof your goals. For example, going to the gym. If you're not going at all, for Pete's sake, don't start saying, I'm going to go for 5 days a week, because you're going to fail. How about starting it at just one and be happy with one and learn to do that for a month? And if you go more, well, that's a bonus. You have to start small with these goals and then set your goals, monthly, even going backwards to weekly or even quarterly, and make them realistic. Don't make them unrealistic. Don't say, I'm going to lose 40 pounds in a month. Of course, that goes back to what we were saying. Don't gain 40 pounds in a month either by going off the wagon. But goal-wise, be smart about it and failure-proof those things.
Dr. Michele, would you speak to the retirees who are watching us today, and they're saying, I can't even do that. How can they slow down the pace and still get that exercise, to get it in and to be healthy, even at, even in their 60s, 70s, and
what have you? Absolutely. Number one is just getting off the couch. Going from sitting to standing is movement. Mm-hmm. And we say, move that body. Even going to and from the mailbox, as you go to and from the mailbox, just deep breathe. Getting that breath moving is a big thing for the system. And the system does slow down, and that's okay. 15-minute walk around the block at a pace that you can tolerate. So it really does become about movement.
I have to tell you, I was looking at some images of you, and I want to be you. I was looking at your biceps, your triceps. I mean, you have some guns on you. Kind of give us the backstory. Here we are, the two of you. What's going on here?
This is what you look like every day.
This is what she really looks like, people.
Yes, she does. We go to the gym every day, and it's amazing what she's able to achieve. And genetically gifted, yes, but she does work hard.
Yeah.
It takes work.
Yes. You have a lot of great help that's out there at the Institute through resources that you all put out to help folks. One thing that you talk about is the pathway to healing. If you could just share about that for a few minutes.
That's one of our favorite projects. It's a free project that we created for people just to have. It's kind of like a trail of breadcrumbs, if you will, to lead people to the actual answer to healing, which we know is Jesus. But we want to give people real tangible examples of what they can do every day physically, talking about eating, talking about exercise, talking about choices and handling those emotions and leading people down that pathway of what causes chronic sickness and disease, what is a catalyst to get that, and what fixes it. Finally, what's the solution? So through the pathway, we're able to get that.
Excellent. And we're going to dig into that a little bit more because we're going to have you guys back. But to connect with Drs. Mark and Michele Sherwood, go to sherwoodwellness.tv or go to our website, harvest-tv.com, and find an easy way to link back. Coming up later, Brian Bush with your prayer request today. But up next, we're going to hear from Pastor Mark Lantz with Connections. We'll be right back.
You know, it only takes $6 to feed one of these children for a whole month. That's why we're asking you to become part of Every Child Every Day. These children have fled the horrors of war from South Sudan, but they're receiving a daily meal, and they're receiving not just food, but the hope of a brighter future. Whatever it is that you can do, we need your help today because the children keep coming out of South Sudan, and we need to feed them. We can't say to one, you can have lunch today, but sorry, no lunch for you.
Come now, let us reason together, says the Lord. Though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they are red like crimson, they shall become like wool. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that at the proper time he may exalt you, casting all your anxieties on him, because he cares for you. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
So we started a conversation on Tuesday about the account of the wise men in the Christmas story. We're using it to discuss a subject I've entitled In Pursuit of His Christmas Presence. You see, my friend, the most important thing this Christmas, it's not the presence under the tree, but rather it's the presence of God in your life. So we talked about the desire to pursue His presence, and today I want to discuss the distraction to pursuing His presence. Let's go to Matthew chapter 2 and verse 8. Speaking of Herod, he sent them to Bethlehem, and he said, "Go, search diligently for the young child, and when you've found him, bring me word again that I may come and worship him also." Now, Herod was a wicked and ungodly leader. He was hated by those not only within his own country, but even his own family. History records that Herod was so jealous of his favorite wife, he had 10 of them, that he finally killed her, as well as her grandfather, her mother, his brother-in-law. He even killed 3 of his own sons, not to mention numerous subjects. He was an insecure leader. He was scared to death that this new king of Judea would overrule his authority. So he comes in the back door, so to speak, under the guise of wanting to worship Christ, when in reality, his intent was to slaughter him. And that's why the Bible records of these magi in verse 12, being warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. You see, God wants you getting as far as possible away from any distraction to worship. The enemy's going to do his flat level best to keep you from pursuing the presence of God. Friend, what's distracting you today? What is standing in the way of you pursuing his presence? Is it the problems of life that are distracting you from worship? Have you allowed the problem you're facing to become bigger, more dominating in your life than God is? Are the people of your life distracting you from worship? You know, too many times we allow a breakdown in human relationships to create a breakdown in our divine relationship with God. We think that because somebody close to us may have failed us, that God is going to fail us. We think that because somebody we loved walked out on us, that God is going to walk out on us. Friend, we're breaking through that distraction today, right here, right now. Together, we are agreeing that we are going to break through what the enemy is trying to bring against us. And together, we're claiming that this Christmas, we will pursue God in spirit and in truth. No matter what we're facing, no matter what we're going through, nothing is going to keep us from His presence today. It's His presence that will truly make this the best Christmas that you have ever had.
Hello, everybody. It's my privilege to be able to pray for your prayer requests that have come in from here in Jerusalem. Let's get started today. It's Jeannie out in Montana. First up, my son and his girlfriend are hellbound, and I'm asking you to stand with me that God will deliver them from drug abuse. Let's pray right now for Jeannie. Our Father, thank you for Jeannie. We ask that you may snatch her son and his girlfriend from drugs and bring them into a complete dependency upon you. Next up is Christine out in Arizona. I'm asking God for a miracle healing to be cancer-free. Let's pray for Christine. Our loving God, we ask that Christine may be free of cancer. We thank you that in you, her life is secure. And lastly, we have Sheila, our partner in faith. I was diagnosed with lung cancer. Please be in agreement with me that God will remove it, and I have a speedy recovery. Well, let's pray right now, friends. Great physician, we thank you for Sheila and ask that her lung cancer be thoroughly removed and she be brought back into health quickly. We pray this and all of our prayers in the mighty name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Friends, just a reminder, you can always contact the set of The Harvest Show at liveatlesea.com. You can reach the hosts, and that's where we're going to go right now.
Thank you, Brian, and we also encourage you to give our 24/7 prayer line a call at 1-800-365-3732. There's somebody there 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, waiting to come in agreement with you in prayer. So if there's something that's troubling you, something that is going on in your life that you need prayer for, and I don't know anybody that doesn't qualify for, somebody is there waiting for you, and there's, of course, other ways to reach them. You can email them at prayer@lesea.com, or if you want to sit down and write it out, put a stamp on it, that's fine, too. Our address, and I assume the mail is going to get here today despite the weather, 61300 Ironwood Road, South Bend, Indiana, 46614. We always look forward to hearing from you. We're always interested in what you have to say. That's why Brian mentioned our email address, live@lesea.com. So if you've ever got a question for a guest or one of us, we're more than happy to take a look at it and answer it. And don't forget, Fridays also bring Choose Your News. Gosh, there's a reason to tune in tomorrow. We hope we'll see you then on the next edition of Harvest.
When Jesus gave his great commission to go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature, he was not just speaking to his disciples, he was speaking to you and me. Through the outreaches of LeSEA Broadcasting's television, shortwave radio, free Bible distribution, and prayer line, souls come to faith and are saved every day. As a financial partner with LeSEA Broadcasting, you too will be investing into the lives of men, women, and children as we proclaim God's word around the world together. LeSEA Broadcasting partners in faith make it possible for millions to hear the word of God in over 190 countries. You can be a partner in faith with us for as little as a monthly gift of $25. Your gifts help LeSEA Broadcasting bring life, hope, and love into a dark world. Call 1-800-365-3732 and tell the prayer operator you want to be a partner in faith. That's 1-800-365-3732. Be a part of the Great Commission.
We want to help you live and pray intentionally in 2017 by sending you one of our beautiful and functional LeSEA Broadcasting Personal Prayer Diary and Daily Planners. Each week in the diary, there's a selected scripture and the chosen country to aid you in praying while you plan your own daily prayers and activities. To get yours, call 1-800-365-3732 and make a minimum gift of just $19. The demand is high and they'll go quickly, so call today, 1-800-365-3732. Show is produced by LeSEA Broadcasting and is viewer supported by people just like you. Thank you for inviting us into your home today.